Hey guys, Steve Caff, IFJUF. Hey, it's Friday evening here. We've got a net here that I picked up on. This is the good old boys and gals Friday night net. Just picked up on it here. I just checked in on Netlogger. There's about six people in front of me, but I want to kind of give you an idea what the noise level is like. We do have some rain clouds and some way off distant thunderstorms, but they're really far off. But I want to give you an idea what the noise floor is doing here. I'll do the DNR here a little bit.
Good deal. Yeah, like I said, you're sounding good.
This is W5WHK. He's in Temple, Wild Bill. He's 10 over. Amazing signal. From Temple, Texas to Abilene. I would say that's about 250 miles.
So we'll
just check in here. We'll kind of listen here for a minute. He's going to go down the list, and he'll eventually call me. When he does, I'll kind of just check in and tell him what's going on in Abilene. They may allow a call here. We'll see. Some stations allow you to make a call to another station, so we'll just kind of listen here and see. They'll let you call someone that's on the roster for you. I don't know. This other guy that's on the air right now, he is from Deer Park, Texas, KJ5DHH. He's from Deer Park, Texas. We're having a hard time pulling him in. I'll try to...
Yeah, you could probably tune it with a tuner,
see if we can,
but he just wouldn't get out.
See if we can bring him in. Got the AM2 on. We're just picking up a lot of noise floor there. This guy's from Deer...
Oh, there you go. Anyway, it's working for you, so...
There's Wild Bill again. See if we can, well, Bill will call us here in a little bit as we go down the line. Again, we are checked in on Netlogger. We're number 19 on the roster, and he's at number 11.
Yeah, I like getting those.
So we may...
Japan coming in and stuff, and I've got a bunch of Russia and all kinds from over there, so...
I'm going to put IPO back on.
It's kind of fun to chase. And
there's Wild Bill right there, S9, just great signal.
I usually don't CQ myself, but when I'm FCA, I just kind of think it's fun to kind of catch what I can see on there.
That Deer Park station is really hard to pull in, but that's okay. What the AM2 does, it just takes the noise floor away.
Let's go to Richard, KJ5GVQ in Oklahoma. Richard, do you have a copy?
Okay, he's going down the list in Chandler, Oklahoma.
KJ5GVQ.
So this is how these nets work. They just kind of go down the list, and I'm fully checked in over here.
Oh, I think that's three strikes. Hopefully we're not out. We'll come back again later. KJ5PBZ, Robert, you have a copy?
Okay, there we go. Robert is in New Caney, Texas. Northy Houston.
Good deal. You're sounding great yourself, Robert. What's going on over New Caney?
Amp one on.
I'm
Katy, Texas.
Well, good deal. You got a little bit of something done. I'll take that.
See, when we got the M2 on, we're too old, but he's up 20 plus.
I'm taking pictures and stuff anyway, doing any kind of honeydew work. Okay, appreciate it, Robert. You take care, and good talking to you too. And come back and see us whenever you can, for sure. KJ5PBZ W5WHK. Oh, let's see if I get all the way over to Missouri and talk to Mike KC0UKA W5WHK.
Missouri.
Oh, I don't know. I'm doing pretty good. You're actually sounding better than you have lately.
And we're running 95 watts tonight.
Well, you just may get a floater. You never know. Or you may get nothing.
See if we can bring him in.
The antenna response, and you can
Well, Roger, yeah, that works. So I do the same kind of thing, zipped in analog. I just put the ICOM here on about a watt and then sweep up and down and see where the low port is, you know, and then you kind of know where it is. I just sweep the VFO with low power and see what happens.
Okay, yeah, Roger that. Yeah, my radio, it doesn't have the scale on it that you can see that on, but that's why I was using the Nano VNA for that, and I really like that, but that, you know, that thing will work for all kinds of different things that you want to do, so I'll probably be using it for other things as well, when I want to gather around and do something, you know, build different interfaces and things like that, over.
Well, Roger, it'll do good. Yeah, it'll do a good sweep for sure. Yeah, I've kind of done the same thing with, I've got this little MFJ antenna analyzer, and I really don't like the thing. It's one of the older models, so that's why I just use the one on the radio. But yeah, I've got to build the dust off of my Nano VNA and actually start using it, because I know it'll probably do me a better job than what I've been doing.
Yeah, Roger that. This is one of the first models that came out. I was looking at them on the web. The newer ones, I think, are a little cheaper than what my son paid for this one. And they're more powerful. You know, you can hook them up to the computer and control them through your computer and, the display, sweep and all of that, the scale on the computer, and I think I'm going to give this one back to my son and go get one of them, over.
Oh, yeah, I think it'd be a wise investment for what they're costing now. You can't buy a good antenna analyzer.
Gary's in McKinney, Texas, which is just north of Dallas.
Yeah, Roger that. So. Well, I think I'll let you go there.
Good signal coming in from McKinney.
When you first called me, and you know, I just hit the key down and looked at the output power, and I wasn't putting anything out, and you know. It worked on CW, and I didn't know what
so we got the,
going
this
on.
Guy going on here, and that's the microphone settings. So we'll see if we'll make a contact.
And,
I think Wild Bill will be able to hear us for sure in Temple. So
because that was disheartening. But anyway, thanks a lot for picking me up, Bill, and you know, signals all around sounded pretty good. So. It sounds like you got a pretty good net tonight. You're running here, you know, 10 over as well. No problem picking your station up. So I've got the dinner bell ringing, so I'm going to have to leave and go in and put some groceries down my throat. So thanks a lot for picking me up, Bill, and have a good weekend. Back to you at W5WHA, NV5 Yankee.
All right, you bet, you Gary. Sounding good, and you got it working fantastic for sure. NV5 White, W5 WHK. What was your call sign again? Kilo Bravo 5 what?
He's doing verbally.
Kilo Bravo 5 Bravo Sierra, is that right? Okay, let me go ahead and pick you up because you're kind of light there. Go ahead there, Bill, and what's going on? You've got the good old boys group here. I'm going to go ahead and get the happy on you just a little bit late there, Bill. But yeah, anyway, I haven't talked on those radios, but I've seen quite a few of them. So it's a good radio, and it's making your trip for sure, Roger.
These are the different settings. See the number changing there? One more guy ahead of me, Harley, in Okamagulia.
Okay, Bill, yeah, I'm in Temple. I see you're in Hockley. I'm not sure exactly where that is, but, I'm in Temple, and, it's good. You probably got an SWR, maybe a little SWR problem, since you can only get 50 watts out via the radio. That's, they usually tune them down when they get over 2-1, so, we'll see, but, I've got a copy on you. Good talking to you, and come back and see us again.
Good. Very cool. Very nice.
Okay, Bill, you betcha. That sounds like I know where you're at, so no problem. KB5BSW5WHK. Have a good evening. K5BR Harley, you got a copy?
All right, we're next here.
Yes, I do. Got this microphone here. I was just getting back in my recliner, and he caught me by surprise. Yeah, I'm listening to the old Kenwood TS2000, and for a long, long time, and I've been enjoying my coffee. I filled up a... We get there, we're digging around in a box. I found an old Baylor. I added 63 feet of wire to it, and made the inset halfway out of it. I only put it up 21 foot high yesterday. And I heard Bill the other day talk about the analyzer. And years ago, when I was still a licensed plumber working at the office, making a little bit of money, I bought me one of those Cohen analyzers, and I paid some good money for that thing. I jumped in about $500 for it, but I considered it money well spent. And I thought, as y'all were talking about the DNA or whatever that thing is, just between men and boys and across the doors. So, but that analyzer still works, just like the door of the brand new. And I like that, being able to open an antenna out there in the yard and sit out there in the yard with an analyzer, a good analyzer. And I recall what you just said between that and the Google line, a good analyzer is money. And you're exactly right. If you want a good analyzer, it's going to cost you $2. Now, I don't know what that thing is going to say, if it's by no one, but I'm doing mine. And it's just...
I believe this guy's in Hockley, Texas, I think. Oh, this is Harley. He's in Okamagulia. It's Oklahoma. Oklahoma, sorry. We're next.
Doing its job, doing a good work.
tonight, pick them in for location, a little bit later on 7-3 ground. Hey, Bob, back to you, bud.
All right there, Ernie. Yep, you never know what you get late at night. Tell you what, yep, you can reach on out there, and if you got the good antenna, that's what makes all the difference for sure. And good talking to you, Ernie, and have a safe weekend. K5BR, W5WHK.
All right, I think we're next.
How about KI5JUF, Steven, you got a copy?
Hey, good evening out there, W5WHK. This is KI5JUF here in Abilene, Texas. Good evening to everyone on the net. Thanks for picking me up here. Your signal over here is 10 over S9. Back to the net control.
Boy, you're sounding good, too. I'll tell you what, though, this is the best sub I hear you better here than I do over there on 80.
Yeah, I copy that. Sounds good, Wild Bill. Good to hear you also on this side here. Everything's good on this side from Abilene. Just got back in this evening from a week up in Salt Lake City. Beautiful up there. Just got back this evening to some cool rain. Everything's cooling down, so everything else is good. Nothing much to report here. Thanks again, and I want to wish everyone a happy Labor Day weekend, and thanks again for picking me up there, Bill. Just got back in, so W5WHK. From KI5JUF, I'll let you have it back and go to the next one. Thank you, sir.
No, you bet you, Steve. Take care, and you have a safe weekend also, and stay out of the traffic for sure. It's probably going to be a wild one this weekend. KI5JUF, W5WHK.
All right, cool. So that's how it works. They go down the list, and that's awesome.
Let's see if I can pick up Will. KC8EXV.
Okay, guys. Well, that's the net there. Pretty cool stuff. That's the good old boys and gals Friday night net, and that's Wild Bill W5WHK in Temple, Texas. He's awesome. So anyway, this is net stuff is fun. I'm really enjoying it. So 73, we'll catch you later.